All right, CDL, pre-trip inspection. First, we're gonna start with the lights. All the lights in front of my vehicle is properly mounted and secured. They're not bent, broke, or cracked, and of the proper color, which is amber on the front and red on the rear. We gotta make sure that the truck is not leaning one side or the other. That would indicate that we have a problem with our suspension, inflation, or the load problem. All right, and we have to make sure that there is no puddles on the ground on the engine compartment. Now let me pop the hood and we're gonna check the passenger side. All right, I'll start from in and work my way out. We have an alternator. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and it's belt driven. The belt itself, it has no cuts, no splits, and it should not have more than 3/4 of an inch of a play. All the wires from the alternator is properly fastened. They're not frayed. I don't see any exposed wires. We have a water pump. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't see any leaks. All the hoses are properly secured at both at all ends. And there's no ridges, bulges, or cuts on the hoses. After that, we got a coolant reservoir. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. It has a cap on, it's present and tight. The hoses, they're properly securely mounted at both ends. They got no bridges, bulges, or cuts. And there's no leaks. It is at the proper range. After that, we got our oil filler and a dipstick. I'll pull out my dipstick, wipe it clean, insert it, pull it again, and check for my oil level. Insert it back. After that, we got our windshield fluid reservoir. It is at the proper range. The hoses have no bridges, bulges, or cuts, and they're securely mounted at all ends. And then we have our exhaust system. I'll follow it back to the exhaust, and I'll check to make sure that there is no signs of a black suit, and it is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. Now let's go to the driver's side. All right, at the driver's side, we have a air compressor. It is gear driven. It has no audible leaks. It's properly mounted and secured. The hoses have no bridges, bulges, or cuts, and they're securely mounted at all ends. All right, now I'll talk about my steering components. And I'll go ahead and start with my steering power steering reservoir. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and it is at the proper level. It has a cap on, tight. All the hoses have no bridges, bulges, or cuts, and they're securely mounted at all ends. All right, the drive shaft. It has the drive shaft and U-joints. It has no excessive play. It's properly mounted and secured. The U-joints are not bent, broke, or cracked, and they're well greased. My steering gearbox. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And the hoses have no bridges, bulges, or cuts. And they're secure at all ends. And then we got our pitman arm, drag link, upper, lower control arms, tie rod. all these components are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. All the bushings are intact, and it's not missing any parts. The castle nut, cutter pins are all present and tight. Now I'll talk about my suspension. I have a front and rear spring hangers. They all properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. It's not missing any hardware. My lift springs, we have multiple lift springs, so we gotta make sure that they're not shifted or scissored. It's not obviously missing. And then we have our U-bolts. They are present and tight, not bent, broke, or cracked, and the bushings are intact. We have a shock absorber. It's properly mounted on top and bottom. Top and bottom, the bushings are intact and it's not leaking. We have a steer axle. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I'll go ahead and talk about my braking system. I have brake lines. It has no abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and securely mounted at both ends. I have a brake chamber. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and I don't hear any audible leaks. I have a slack adjuster and push rod. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. When the brakes are released, you should be able to pull no more than 1 inch. All right. After that, we're going to go talk about our brake linings. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. You shouldn't be less than 1 1/4 inch of material, pad material, and it should be free of oil and grease. I have a brake drum. It's not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't see any bluish color from overheating, and it should be free of oil or grease. And then the rim, inside and outside. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and there is no illegal welds. Inside and outside of my tire, the walls have no abrasions, bulges, or cuts. It's properly seated to the rim, inside and outside. The top of my tire, it should be worn evenly, and the dead thread should be not less than 4/32 of an inch, and it should be virgin radial on the front tires. All right, I have a valve stem. It has a metal cap on. It's not bent, broke, or cracked, and I don't hear any audible leaks. I will check the valve stem. I'll check the inflation of the tire with the tire gauge, and it should be between 100 to 125 PSI. All my lug nuts are present and tight. I don't see any rust, any shiny threads or rust rails, which would indicate that they're loose. And a hub seal is properly mounted and secured, not missing any hardware. The bolts are present and tight, and it's not leaking. All right, I'm done with the engine compartment. Now I'll do the side and coupling. I will start with my mirror bracket. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. All the bolts and nuts are tight. The door has no holes. The door handle is working properly, opens and closes. All right. The door seal is present and tight. It's not missing, except for this. I'll definitely report that to maintenance. All right. The door has no sag, which tells me that the hinges are present and tight. All the hinges are present and tight. All right. My fuel tank and straps. It's not bent, broke, or cracked, and the fuel tank is not leaking. There's no visual leaks. The fuel tank cap is present and tight. It has a metal chain inside and a rubber seal. All right, the fuel line is present. I don't see, it doesn't have any abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and I don't see any leaks on it. My steps. It's not bent, broke, or cracked, and there is no debris that will make me slip and fall. All right. My battery box and batteries inside of it. It's not bent, broke, or cracked. The batteries have no corrosion on it, and the wires are properly fastened. The wires have no abrasions. The wires, it's not frayed. All right. My air tanks, they're properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't hear any audible leaks. The hoses have no abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and they're properly mounted at all ends. All right. Then I have a catwalk. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and it's free of any debris that will make me slip and fall. I have my frame, all the frame. It's not bent, broke, or cracked. There is no illegal welds, illegal holes on it. I have my cross member, I-beam, and a torsion bar. They're all properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And all the hardwares are present. I have a drive shaft. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and it's free of any foreign objects. The U-joints are well greased, and they're not broken. All right, now I'll talk about my suspension. I have a front spring hanger. It is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. All the bolts and nuts are tight. On the rear, on the back of my suspension, I have an air brake, airbag. It doesn't have any abrasions, bulges, or cuts. It's properly mounted on top and bottom, and I don't hear any audible leaks. My lift springs. There are multiple lift springs, so we got to make sure that they are not scissored or shifted. They are present, not bent, broke, or cracked. I got U-bolts, two U-bolts. They're present and tight. They're not bent, broke, or cracked. And then the bushings are intact. All right, I got my shock absorber. It's properly mounted on top and bottom, not bent, broke, or cracked. The bushings are intact, and it's not leaking. All righty. I'll talk about my braking system, my brake hoses. Brake hoses are, they don't have any abrasions, bulges, or cuts. They're properly mounted at all ends, and I don't hear any audible leaks. My brake chamber, this is a brake chamber. It's properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and I don't hear any audible leaks. I have push rod, slack adjuster push rod on the back of my brake chamber. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. When the brakes are released, you should be able to pull no more than 1 inch. After that, we have brake linings. Brake linings are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And there should be at least 1 1/4 of pad material. The brake drum is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't see any bluish color, which would indicate from overheating. And it should be free of oil and grease. Inside and outside of my rim, it's properly mounted and secured, and I don't see any illegal welds. Not bent, broke, or cracked. All right, now, my dual, okay. There should be no gap between my rims, and there should be no foreign objects in between my tires. My dual sides of my tire, there are no abrasions, bulges or cuts, and they are properly seated to the rim, and I don't hear any audible leaks. The top of my dual tires, they evenly worn. There are no cuts, no splits, and then the dead thread should be not less than 2/32 of an inch. All right. My valve stem, my both valve stems. And the other one is there. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't hear any audible leaks. They have the metal cap on. I'll check the inflation with the tire gauge, and they should be around between 100 to 125 PSI. All my lug nuts are present and tight. I don't see any shiny threads or rust rails, which would indicate that they're loose. And my axle seal, all the bolts and nuts are present and tight. I don't see any leaks. And my splash guard is properly mounted and secured and has a proper clearance from the ground. And the mud flap is missing, so I'll definitely report that to maintenance. Now I'll do the coupling. I'll start with my electrical wire. It's properly secured at both ends with a safety latch. It's present and tight. The wire itself, it has no abrasions, bulges or cuts, no exposed wires or frayed wires. I'll talk about my emergency line and service line. It has no abrasions, bulges or cuts, and it's properly secured at my tractor and secured to the trailer with the glad hands. The glad hands are properly mounted and secured. They're not bent, broke or cracked, and then the rubber bushings are intact. Now I don't hear any audible leaks. And all my lines, they got proper clearance from the catwalk. All right. Apron, it is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. It doesn't have any legal welds. My skid plate, it is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And there is no daylight or a gap between apron and the skid plate. My pivot pin is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. Release handle is on the lock position, not bent, broke, or cracked. My platform and platform bolts, they all present. The bolts are present, not bent, broke, or cracked. All right. On back here, inside we have a locking jaw and a kingpin. We got to make sure that the locking jaw is securely secured around the kingpin, and they are well greased. And then over here, we got to make sure that we have proper clearance from the back of my tractor to the landing gear. That's when we are turning. And the back of my the lights on the back of my tractor are present. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and of the proper color, red. All right, I'll do my trailer. The header board, I'll start from the top, work my way down. Clearance lights, they are present and tight, and of the proper color, not bent, broke, or cracked. The header board and a sidewall. There are no holes. All the hinges are present and tight. And the frame. All the frame around my trailer are present and tight. It's not... what was the word? Oh, man, I got to breathe, man. The frame is not what was the word I forgot?
Twisted.
It's not twisted. All the rivets are present and tight. And it has a 50% DOT tape all the way down. Coming around, we have cross members. All these are cross members. We gotta make sure that none of them is missing. We have to make sure that they all securely mounted. And it has a wooden floor. We have to inspect the floor, make sure there are no holes on the floor. All right, going down. We have a landing gear. Landing gear as an all. It's fully raised from the ground. It has a proper clearance from the ground. And it's not bent, broke, or cracked. The release handle, which is on the other side, it's on the stored weight position. Going down. We're gonna inspect the axle. On this trailer, we don't have a shock absorber in a airbag. Instead of that, we have a torque arm and torsion bar. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. We have a spring hanger, front and rear spring hangers. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. We have multiple spring lifts. We have to make sure that none of them is missing, not bent, broke, or cracked. They're not shifted, not scissored. We have U-bolts. We have to make sure that they are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And then the bushings are intact. After that, we're gonna talk about the braking system. We have brake lines. All the brake lines have no abrasions, bulges, or cuts. They all properly mounted at all ends. And I don't hear any audible leaks. The brake chamber is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And I don't hear any audible leaks. On the back of my brake chamber, we have a slack adjuster and push rod, which is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. With the brakes released, you should be able to pull no more than 1 inch. And when the brakes are applied, it should be at 90 degree angle. From the brake chamber, push rod, we're gonna talk about brake linings. They are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. It should be free of oil and grease. And it should have at least 1 1/4 inch of pad material. The brake drums, they are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. I don't see any bluish color from overheating, and it should be free of oil and grease. The rims, inside and outside, it is properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and no illegal welds. There should be no daylight or a gap between rims, and it should be free of any foreign objects between the tires. The side walls of my dual tires, I don't see any abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and it's properly seated to the rim, and I don't hear any audible leaks. The top of my tire, my dual tires, are evenly worn, and then the dead thread should be not less than 2/32 of an inch. All right. The lug nuts. All the lug nuts are present and tight. No, I don't see any shiny threads or rust rails, which would indicate that they're loose. All right. And I would check my valve stems on my dual tires, that they're properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked. And I'll check the inflation with the tire gauge, should be between 100 to 125 PSI. And then the metal cap is on. And then the hub seal is present. All the bolts are present and tight. and it's not leaking. All right, it's my marker light. It's present, all the bolts and nuts are present. It's not bent, broke, or cracked, and it's of the proper color, red. The back of my trailer, I'll start from the top and work my way down. Clearance lights, they are properly mounted and secured, not bent, broke, or cracked, and they're of the proper color, which is red. The door, all my hinges are present and tight. The door has no holes. The door latch is in the lock position. Door handle is present and tight. It's not bent, broke, or cracked. Tail lights, they're not bent, broke, or cracked and of the proper color, red. The DOT bumper is not bent, broke, or cracked. It's properly mounted. And we have 100% of DOT tape along the bumper. All right, and at this point, the mud flap. The mud flaps, both of my mud flaps are properly mounted and secured. There are no cuts on them. They have proper clearance from the ground. And at this point, I'll check this side of my trailer and the truck, same as I did the other side.